Anxiety is a normal feeling or reaction as a sign of imminent danger. But anxiety is considered not normal if it occurs in a situation that occurs continuously. The intensity increases and can interfere with daily activities or is referred to as a disorder called anxiety disorder. The causes of anxiety depend on each individual. Rising expenses. The current situation has changed as the cost of living is increasing. Also, wages for many people are not increasing. Therefore, inflation contributes to stress partly because of this. Family responsibilities. Some university students have many family problems that cause them anxiety while they are studying. One of these problems is the illness of a family member, such as a parent, which requires the student to remain close to the patient. These problems affect the student academically. Unable to find a job. Unable to find a job due to a variety of situations and circumstances is one of the causes of financial anxiety. There is no doubt that part-time work for underprivileged students is very important to meet the needs of life, other than for the purpose of paying tuition fees and house rent. Every problem must begin with a cause and inevitably end with a way to overcome it. Talk to someone you trust. Sometimes, you just need to let out how you're feeling with no real plan for a solution. I have many problems in my mind. It can be the start of a conversation that helps you process the stress of a hard day. Blow off some steam. When one's mind is running a mile a minute, calculating income and spending is difficult for everyone. Try taking a 5 to 10 minutes break to center yourself. Meet counselor. Sometimes we need some expert advice about our finances. That's where a counselor can come in.
In conclusion, anxiety is a dangerous problem involving a person's mental, and it is certain every problem has a cause and a method to overcome it. Based on the Quran in Surah Al-Baqarah, verse 286, Allah says that لَا يُكَلِّفَ اللَّهُ نَفْسًا إِلَّا وُسْعَهَا لَهَا مَا كَسَبَتْ وَعَلَيْهَا مَا اكْتَسَبَتْ رَبَّنَا لَا تُؤَاخِذْنَا إِنْ نَسِينَا أَوْ أَخْطَأْنَا. That means Allah does not judge a soul except with that within its capacity. It will have the consequence of what good it has gained, and it will bear the consequence of what evil it has earned. Last but not least, according to Jack Benny, he states that try to save something while your money is small. It's impossible to save after you begin to earn more.